I want to start with axillary skeleton. And that means spine, right? That's head to the butt. So let's start there. Who has a low back issue? Ache. Who wakes up stiff in the morning? In the low back. What the hell? I got 50 pull-ups, why am I stiff? You cannot take a piece of the body out of context and not know that what happens downstream or what happens upstream doesn't affect the thing you're talking about. If you have really, really tight hips, you know who I'm talking about, men particularly in here, right? You can't cross your legs, you can't sit Indian style, indigenous person style. You can't lunge, you can't split, you can't do these things. Know that that's absolutely going to affect your low back. If you have sacrum problems or problems in this low back, the more you transfer energy through a tight hip, the more it's going to trash your low back. And you think we generate any force with these long levers? Yeah, in CrossFit, you bet we do. So understand that we can't talk about these things kind of one-on-one without kind of taking them out of context, but we're gonna attempt to do that a little bit, okay? So what we've got here is most important. We're thinking about spine is from here to here. When we talk about midline stabilization, which is being able to have the capacity to maintain neutral spine under load, we're talking about from here to here, okay? So go ahead and get into a good deadlift setup for me real quick. Okay, so best deadlift setup, back is flat, stable spine under load. Now, I'm gonna hold your head, go stand up for me, stand up. Is her spine in line? Negative. What's happened? She's broken at the cervical spine, right? And now she's no longer maintaining that midline stabilization concept. Is that okay? Yeah, if she needs to see where the hell she's going to land for a snatch, for a clean, that she's got to look up a little bit, right? But understanding our premise, we have best fit, best capacity to generate the most force, and deviation from that does what? Sets me up for potential dysfunction, sets me up for less force production. So when you go to pick up a heavy rock, is your spine going to be real rounded? Are your shoulders going to be in it? Yeah, a little bit. You can't lift a 400-pound rock like this and not be in a kind of less than ideal position. That's okay, as long as you have the functional tolerance to be in those positions and be able to buffer that, right? Shoulders are forward. Do we, anyone you know, do any good lifting like this? Negative, right? So what we're talking about is how do we keep these ideal positions? That's that capacity to maintain neutral spine, under load, under tension, from head to kind of the base of the sacrum.